I'm Kate Hahn with TV Insider, and we are speaking with the stars of the new Netflix series Vikings Valhalla, set in the 11th century.
The story I want to tell is not of me. It belongs to a group of friends. The Greenlanders. Leif Erikson. My friend. My brother. Captain through the storms of wind and mutiny. He settled rough waters and made the passage calm. Brother.
Sam Corlett, you play Leif Erikson, who's a very famous Viking. He's known to be a big explorer. But when we first meet him in the show, he's not there yet. Tell us a little bit about his path to fame as this show goes on.
Sure. Yeah, no, in this series, we're definitely looking at like the origin stories of these legends. And I think for me, it was very important to go back to, you know, the very human nature of him and growing up in Greenland in the very harsh environments there and under probably a very harsh household, his father being Eret, notoriously one of the most violent Vikings. So it was important for me to, you know, pick out what his purpose was, which was, I found, just looking after those that were around him, looking after the people that he loved. And that takes him to the so-called heights of the Viking world.
Yeah, and he looks out for them with his axe quite a bit. Tell us about shooting those fight scenes, because you start scrapping pretty early.
Yeah, well, I think scrapping comes to him, you know, because of his father, he's kind of picked on. I think the fight scenes were incredible to work on. I think anything that involves all of myself is really exciting for me. And to work with Richard Ryan and the stunt team, Richard Ryan, he was our stunt coordinator, and he'd worked on Troy with Brad Pitt and Eric Banner and Sherlock Holmes with Robert Downey Jr. And so we were in good hands in that aspect. And the stunt team were really incredible in choreographing these amazing, like, violent dances. You know, we're so in tune with each other, but we're portraying these scenes which are quite, violent. It was really, dynamic, but it was a welcomed aspect of the character that kind of bled into every other scene.
Yeah, bled into, literally. Leo Suter, you play Harold Sigerson, and he actually notices Leif because of his fighting skills. Tell us about how they meet and where Harold thinks his life is going, and it kind of takes a left turn.
Yeah, well, how they met on set is one of my favorite stories, because I had just completed a love scene with Freydis. Freydis is Leif's sister. And Harold is in a state of undress when Leif arrives in the opposite, in a big fur coat. And so these two men are looking at each other and sizing each other up. And you're exactly right. I think Harold identifies early on that there's something special, something mystical about this man, and that he's destined for great things. And one of the joys over the course of the series is playing the fact, this sort of Butch Cassidy Sundance Kid relationship, and the fact that as a double act, as a bromance, there are elements that these two characters can really help each other with. It's that yin-yang relationship. So, they size each other up first episode, and then they realize they're better together.
Leo, could you just quickly tell us a little bit about Harold, his title when we first meet him, and what he wants more than anything else?
Absolutely. He's a prince of Norway, and he wants to become king. And it's a pretty simple black and white view of the world. And I think he also thinks it's going to be quite easy to just become king. But one of the truths of the Viking world and inheritance and kingship is that it's a messy, dirty business. And he learns that the hard way. But he's going to lean upon some new friendships and new relationships to help him navigate a tricky, bloodthirsty Viking world.
Fridagustavsson, you play Freydis, Eric's daughter. Now, her brother is Leif Erikson. Mm-hmm. They kind of are a team, but she really carries the pagan flag of this Viking culture. Can you talk about that and how dangerous it is for her to stick to those pagan ways?
Absolutely. So Freydis and Leif, they grew up in Greenland, in kind of the outskirts of the Viking world, where they're blissfully more or less unaware that the world of, you know, where the majority of the Vikings live has drastically changed. Freyda's, you know, that she grew up with her beliefs. She's incredibly strong in them. It's what she identifies with. But after, you know, she's a survivor of a horrible sexual assault, and she has her beliefs to kind of back her into her quest for revenge. And like you said, it's a very dangerous position for her to be in. When she first arrives in Kattegat, she's almost radicalized. You know, she doesn't have the understanding that people are entitled to have other beliefs because she's so focused on her own revenge. And in the meeting of Jarl Håkon, she's taught tolerance. She's taught the virtue of listening and to open your mind. So it's a very personal journey for her and to explore her spirituality.
And Jarl Håkon, Carolyn Henderson, that's your character. Tell us about her. She's an extremely powerful woman ruling over Kattegat. And also she is carrying on those pagan ways. It's kind of a refuge for pagans in a world that's turning very Christian.
Yeah, you're right about that. And unlike Frida's character, Freydis, she's in the midst of everything, where everything is changing rapidly. You know, it's such a hard time. I mean, things are really sort of going from peace to war, and she knows this is happening, and she has to try to rule through tolerance and acceptance, but she knows what's coming, right? So it's a difficult time for her. And then she meets Freydis and she sees like hope, a future, something that could carry a torch, you know, because she knows this is probably not good what's going on. So it's an amazing character, and it's an amazing partnership with Frida to be able to portray these strong women in that particular time and age.
Yeah, it's not something we see a lot in the 11th century in entertainment.
Vikings Valhalla premieres Friday, February 25th on Netflix. For more insider videos like this, click subscribe.